Greetings, my dear boys and girls, our dear candidates of Global Junior School. Welcome to our science lesson. Previously, we are learning about machines, but specifically, we are looking at inclined planes. What did we say an inclined plane is? Someone can tell us? Okay, I'm waiting for you. Okay, yes, we say that an inclined plane is a slanting surface, or an inclined plane is a sloping surface. And we gave different examples of inclined planes. Can we remind ourselves, children, of the examples of inclined planes? Okay, yes. Can you mention them? We have ladders, okay. We also have winding rods. We have a ramp, yes, and the others. So those are some of the examples of inclined planes that we have. However, what should come in your mind is, how do we make use of the inclined planes? How important are they to us in our daily life? How useful are these inclined planes? Okay? So one of the uses of inclined planes is they enable us to climb trees. For example, ladders help us to climb trees with less effort. Now, when we look at inclined planes like winding rods, they enable us to climb hills using less effort. When we look at inclined planes like ramps, they enable us to load things on vehicles. Okay? Are we together? Now, today, we are going to look at mechanical advantage of inclined planes. Remember, in our previous lesson, we learned about mechanical advantage, dear children. Can somebody tell us what mechanical advantage is? Yes? Okay. We said that mechanical advantage is the ratio of the load to the effort. Or we can also say that mechanical advantage is the number of times a machine simplifies work. Okay? Now, today we are going to basically find mechanical advantage of slopes or mechanical advantage of inclined planes. And let us look at our first example. It says, find the mechanical advantage of the inclined plane below. Which inclined plane are we talking about there? We have this inclined plane. We have that inclined plane, and we want to find its mechanical advantage. You can discover that the effort is given as 20 newtons, and the load is given as 80 newtons. Now, when we are finding the mechanical advantage of an inclined plane, we shall still use the same formula, which says that the mechanical advantage is equal to load out of effort. Remember, mechanical advantage does not have units, dear children. We cannot tell the units for mechanical advantage because it is a ratio of forces. Usually, ratios do not have units. Okay? Now, using our formula, we can now simplify it and we say MA is equal to L out of E, where L stands for load and E stands for effort. Then we can say that will be equal to, what is our load? Our load is 80 newtons. 80 newtons. Out of our effort, which effort do you apply there to overcome that load of 80 newtons? You apply an effort of 20 newtons. Therefore, we shall cancel the units first. Because remember, mechanical advantage is a ratio. So we don't need those units. We cancel out those units such that we shall remain with the only 80 out of 20. Okay? Now, from here, we can now cancel we can now cancel the zeros first, okay, so that we remain with a smaller number that we can easily calculate, okay? Dear children, I want you to be very critical about this. I want you to follow these steps very well. Now, we are going to divide 8 out of 2 because we have already cancelled the zeros. Therefore, we shall say by 2, that is 1. 2 is the smallest factor that divides both 2 and 8. So, we say by 2, then we get 1. Then, when we divide 8 by 2, what shall we get? We shall get 4. Therefore, that 4 becomes our mechanical advantage. Therefore, we can say that mechanical advantage is equal to 4. It does not have any units. So, you underline your answer like that. Then, let us go to our example number 2. What does it say? Find the mechanical advantage of the ladder below. So there you have a ladder and it's leaning against the wall. Now, you have the effort of 20 kilogram force and a load of 60 kilogram force. KGF stands for kilogram force. Therefore, we shall go to our solution using the same formula. Mechanical advantage equals load out of effort. And that will take us to what is the load we are overcoming, dear children? We are overcoming the load of 60 kilogram force out of, what is the effort? Look at that diagram. Okay, the effort is 20 kilogram force. Now, we shall not continue from there just like that. We shall first cancel the units. We shall first cancel the kilogram force by kilogram force such that we remain with completely nothing. Okay? Then we shall now go to our next step and say we are remaining with 60 out of 20. 60 out of 20. Therefore, we shall cancel this 0 first and then cancel also that 0. And then that's what will happen. When we cancel the zeros, we shall now remain with a smaller number that we can easily divide. Therefore, what is the smallest factor that divides both 2 and 6? That factor is 2. So by 2, what do we get? 1. And 6 by 2, what do we get? 3. So 3 becomes our mechanical advantage. Then we shall say mechanical advantage is equals to 3. That means that this ladder simplifies work how many times? 3 times. Okay? So that is its mechanical advantage. Now, there is a scenario or a situation whereby you are not given the effort and you are also not given the load, okay? But instead, you are given the distance moved by the effort and the distance moved by the load. So let us look at that statement. Finding mechanical advantage of an inclined plane when the distance moved by the load and the effort are given. Therefore, we shall have first of all to understand what that means. What do we mean by the distance moved by the effort and the distance moved by the load? Let us look at that diagram. That is our ladder. Now, when we look at that ladder very well, you discover that this, from this point here, going vertically upwards, that is, for example, the wall, is the distance moved by the load. So the load moves a shorter distance than the effort in an inclined plane. You find that when you are using an inclined plane, the load will move a shorter distance. So that is what we call LOD. LOD stands for load distance or distance moved by the load. The load moves a shorter distance than the effort. Then, on the other side, looking at this arrow, this is the distance that the effort moves. So the effort moves all the way through this slope. The effort moves that distance, which is longer than the distance moved by the load. So this is what we call distance moved by effort, or we can call it the effort distance, ED, effort distance. So in some situations, dear candidates, you are given the distance moved by the load, which is this, from here up to here is the distance moved by the Lord. Take note of that. And then this side is the distance that is moved by the effort. Which of those two is longer than the other? You find that the distance moved by the effort is longer than the distance that is moved by the Lord. Therefore, let us look at this. E distance for effort distance, or distance moved by the effort, whereas LO distance for distance moved by the Lord. Now, which formula shall we use? We shall say mechanical advantage equals to distance moved by effort out of distance moved by the Lord. Okay? The distance that the effort moves out of the distance that the Lord moves. Please don't change it the other way around. Please follow that. Because the effort distance is longer, that's why we use it as the numerator, and then the Lord distance is shorter, that's why we use it as the denominator. Therefore, MA equals to effort distance out of Lord distance. Okay? Now, let us look at our first example. Find the mechanical advantage of the inclined plane below. What is the distance moved by the Lord? The Lord moves 5 meters, whereas the effort moves 10 meters. So, to find the mechanical advantage there, dear candidates, we shall just say that mechanical advantage is equal to, yes, what is mechanical advantage equal to? Distance moved by effort out of distance moved by the Lord. Or you can say that mechanical advantage equals to effort distance out of Lord distance. What distance does the effort move? So we shall say mechanical advantage is equals to what is the distance moved by the effort? 10 meters out of which distance does the Lord move? Okay. The Lord moves 5 meters. Therefore, 10 meters is for effort distance and 5 meters is for Lord distance. Now, we shall cancel the units because mechanical advantage does not have any units. So, we cancel the meters and we remain with only 10 out of 5. And therefore, we shall now divide 10 and 5 by the smallest factor. Which factor is that? 5 by 5? 1. So, when you divide 5 by 5, you get exactly 1. You have 5 oranges you are giving to 5 children. Each child will receive 1 orange. Then, 10 by 5, what do you get? When you divide 10 by 5, what do you get? We shall get 2. Therefore, 2 becomes our mechanical advantage. Are we together? That is, if you are given the effort distance and the load distance. Now, let us go ahead to the activity. Our activity says, study the diagram below and use it to answer the questions that follow. That is our diagram. Now, this is a wall. This one here is a wall. But on that wall, there are 2 ladders. For example, put one ladder on the other side and another ladder on the other side. Now, here is the question. Which of the 2 ladders do you think less effort is applied? Now, when you follow that very well, whenever an inclined plane is longer, whenever the slope is longer, less effort is used. Okay? When the slope becomes longer, that means less effort will be used. But when the slope is short, that means it will become steep and you have to use much effort. I want you to take an example of climbing a wall. Can you climb the wall just vertically upwards without using an inclined plane? It becomes very hard. So when you use an inclined plane, you easily climb with less effort. Now, let us look at those questions. Which of the slopes requires less effort in order to overcome the load? Give a reason for your answer in A above. That means if you have said that it's slope A or slope B, why do you say so? And then we also have find the mechanical advantage of slope B if an effort of 10 newtons is applied. Give one use of a ladder to a builder. If the mechanical advantage of slope A is 2, find the effort applied. So that is our activity, dear candidates. I want to thank you. And I want to urge you to always sanitize, wash your hands regularly with soap and clean water. And avoid going to crowded places. Coronavirus is real, and we still need you alive. Dear candidates, stay safe. I remain Teacher John Ikorat. Thank you.